Previously, we learned what is exception safety. Now let's put it to use. As we know, apart from no except, the safest exception safety guarantee is the strong one, which states that in case an exception is thrown, the state of involved objects does not change. This is the one we should aim for if possible and, of course, practical. The one operation which is inherently difficult to keep that guarantee is copy assignment. When you assign one complex object to another, and by complex, I mean having members which you can throw during copying, you need to somehow solve the problem of a potential throw in the middle of the operation. Fortunately, the copy and swap idiom solves that problem. Let's make a basic example using our trusted std vector. Let's make a class. Here I will just use a struct widget. Let's say as member vector of ints vector. Not very original, but why the hell not? And let's create our copy assignment operator. Well, first let's maybe follow the rule of five and create all constructors and operators. Default one. Copy constructor. Have the move constructor. And now we are getting to something interesting. Let's make a copy assignment operator. For now, let's leave it empty. And defaulted move assignment operator. Default. Good. Okay. So here we are inside our copy assignment operator. What would be its, well, natural body? Vector equals other vector and return this. Looks simple, right? But it has one problem. It doesn't have the strong exception safety guarantee because copying a vector might throw and you will lose the state of the current object. If we know that copying a vector can throw and if the contents change, since the vector copy assignment operator only provides the basic guarantee, we need to figure out how to increase that guarantee to the strong one. But how can we work around the underlying weaker one? First, let's make an assumption, or maybe rather an axiom. Let's assume that moving this object, widget, is no except. This actually holds true for our simple example here. Given that, we know that we can use moves in our copy assignment operator to get the no except guarantee. This also implies we have a no except swap operation, since swapping tries to use moves if possible. But what should we swap or move since we only have an object we need to copy, right? We don't want to move anything from the other object here. The answer is simple. Use a temporary copy of the object we are copying from and swap it with ourselves. And it looks like this. We are making a temporary object. Let's call it temporary. And we copy the contents of other inside. This can throw. Now let's go a step further. Let's swap the contents. Of our vector and temp vector. Of course, in normal code, when you have more complex cases, you will probably make your own swapping method or a free function. But for the sake of this simple example, let's simply swap those two vectors. And now we have achieved the strong exception guarantee. How? Let's follow the logic. We first create a temporary object using copy construction. If this froze, the current object, this, is left unchanged. Therefore, we have the strong exception guarantee at this point. We then swap the temporary object, well, the contents, with ourselves. Since we asserted that swap is no except because move is no except, this operation cannot throw. So we keep the previously established strong exception guarantee. The temporary object, when it goes out of scope, is destroyed, then simply freeing all the previously created resources. And this operation, if you remember, is also no except. Well, of course, at least it should be. No destructor should ever throw. In other words, the only thing which can throw in this copy assignment operator is this copy construction, and it leaves the contents of our current object unchanged. With only those two simple lines, we have achieved the strong exception guarantee. Even if class members, in our case only the vector, only has the weaker guarantee, only the basic one. As you can see, it's a very simple trick which can make your code much safer. Well, at least more predictable. If you can, if you need, use copy and swap. It's a good thing to do. Hopefully you learned something from this short video. If you'd like to see more lessons, click subscribe, give thumbs up, comment below, and I see you in the next one.